You know, in Luke chapter 18, we're right in the middle of some of the greatest teachings in the life of the ministry of Jesus. And right in the middle of this discourse on parables, Jesus is kind of interrupted. Now, this is a bit lengthy, but let me read to you this account from Luke chapter 18. In verse 18 of chapter 18, Luke records for us, "Once a religious leader asked Jesus this question, 'Good teacher, what should I do to inherit eternal life?' Jesus asked, 'Why do you call me good? Only God is truly good. But to answer your question, you know the commandments. You must not commit adultery or murder or steal. You must not testify falsely and honor your father and mother.' And the man replied, 'I've obeyed all these commandments since I was young.' And when Jesus heard this answer, he said, 'There's still one thing you haven't done. Sell all your possessions and give the money to the poor, and you will have treasure in heaven. Then come, follow me.' But when the man heard this, he became very sad, for he was very rich. And when Jesus saw this, he said, 'How hard it is for the rich to enter the kingdom of God. In fact, it's easier for a camel to go through the eye of a needle than for a rich person to enter into the kingdom of God.' Those who heard this said, 'Then who in the world can be saved?' And he says, 'What is impossible for people is possible with God.'" See, here's the interesting thing. Jesus encounters this man who asks, "Lord, what must I do to be saved?" And Jesus kind of cuts through all the issues straight to his heart and recognizes, what I ultimately want is the allegiance of your heart. Not to trust in maybe your possessions or maybe your position, but to trust in the person of Jesus. In this individual's life, this would be evidenced by giving all that he put his trust in, his security in, letting those things go and saying, "Jesus, you're the one. You're the one who can rebuild. You're the one who can restore. You're the one who can lead and direct and guide my life." And when this man heard this, he went away sorrowful. See, for him, he rather trusted in his possessions, maybe his position, than the person of Jesus. But see, here's the thing. The greatest reward we can have is not on this side of eternity, but in heaven. And the Word of God teaches us not to store up treasures here where maybe moth or rust or even COVID could destroy, but to store up treasures in heaven. This morning, let me encourage you, may your heart be allegiant to the One who owns all the riches of heaven and earth. Let go of that which holds you and hold fast to Jesus, for He truly is the One who can restore and rebuild our souls.